Hi everybody, this is Dr. Rajalakshmi, Assistant Professor from CSE Department of RMT Engineering College. Today's session is Mathematical Analysis of Non-Recursive Algorithms. Let us see the general plan for analyzing time efficiency of non-recursive algorithms. Step 1. Decide on parameter indicating an input size. Second step is identify the algorithm's basic operation. Basic operation in the sense the most time consuming operation present in the algorithm. Then we have to check whether the number of times the basic operation is executed depends only on the size of an input, or otherwise it depends on some additional property of the input also. If it depends on some additional property also, then we have to do all the three cases of analysis: worst case, average case and best case analysis. Otherwise, it is not needed. Then set up a sum expressing the number of times the algorithm's basic operation is executed. Then in the fifth step, we have to use the standard formulas and rules of sum manipulation in order to find the closed form formula for the count, or otherwise establish its order of growth. The first example is maximum element. It is a problem of finding value of the largest element in the list of n numbers. Here we are using a for loop. Inside the initially the very first element is stored in the variable maxval. Then inside this for loop, the content of maxval is compared with all other remaining values present in the array. And always we are keeping the largest element in the maxval variable. Then at last, after the completion of all the comparisons, the value of maxval variable is written as the output because it is containing the largest value in it. This is what is the algorithm. It is a non-recursive algorithm. Now we are going to analyze this algorithm. Actually, the number of elements present in the array is the size of the input. And the first step is over. Now we are going to find the basic operation. As we know already, the most time consuming operation present in the algorithm is called as the basic operation. Generally, the operation which is present inside the looping statement is going to be the time consuming operation. Inside the for loop, in this algorithm, inside this for loop, two operations are there. One is comparison operation, another one is the assignment operation. And if you compare the comparison operation and the assignment operation, comparison operation is executing more number of times than this assignment operation. So we have to consider the comparison is as the basic operation. Then in the third step, we have to decide the number of execution of comparisons is same for all the arrays of size n or not. Whether it the number of execution of comparison depends only on the input size, or otherwise it depends on the additional property of the input also. That we have to decide. Actually, in this problem, or based on this particular algorithm, according to this algorithm, the comparison operation depends only on the input size. So we need not do all the three cases of analysis. One common analysis is enough for this problem or for this particular algorithm. Now the fourth step is we are going to set up a summation formula for the count of the basic operation. Now the basic operation is the comparison operation. It is available inside the for loop, and the initial value of the loop control variable is 1, and the final value of the loop control variable is n minus 1. So from I is equal to 1 to n minus 1, for every iteration the comparison operation is going to be executed for only once. So that can be represented as a summation formula here. So sum of I is equal to 1 to n minus 1, 1, sum of 1, where I is equal to 1 to n minus 1, lower limit of I is equal to 1 and the upper limit of I is equal to n minus 1. And we have to find the sum of 1. Okay. here we can apply the formula for summation of 1. That is upper limit minus lower limit plus 1. This is what is the formula. If you apply that formula, we'll be getting n minus 1. So this is what is the number of execution of basic operation, that is the comparison operation. And it is approximately equal to theta of n. The asymptotic notation of n minus 1 is theta of n. This is what is the efficiency of this algorithm. The second example is element uniqueness problem. Element uniqueness problem, here we are going to check whether all the elements in the given array are distinct or not. For this, we are using this algorithm. And in this algorithm, nested for loop we are using. Inside the nested for loop, we are comparing the elements of the array. And if suppose if there is any duplication, then this if statement will be true and the control will come out after returning the false value. If suppose if there is no duplication at all, then the control will come out of the nested for loop and it will be returning true as the answer. So this is what is the algorithm. And here also the number of elements present in the array is going to be the input size. And in the second step, we have to identify the basic operation. As we know already, the most time consuming operation is going to be the basic operation. And obviously, the operation which is available inside the innermost for loop is going to be the most time consuming operation, because that operation is going to be repeated for multiple number of times, more number of times than the other operations. So according to this particular algorithm, the element comparison A of I and A of J, so is the basic operation. Now we have to check whether the number of execution of basic operation depends only on the input size, or otherwise it depends on the additional property of the input also. Actually, it depends on the additional property of the input also. So we have to do all the three cases of analysis. Now I'm going to show only the worst case analysis of this algorithm. Since the basic operation is available inside two nested for loops, we are using two summation operations for finding the number of execution of the basic operation. For every iteration, the basic operation is going to be executed for only once. That is why we are writing 1 here. So first of all, we have to apply the innermost summation operator on the value 1, and on the result of this innermost summation operation, we have to apply the outermost summation operation. Now, apply the formula for sum of 1, upper limit minus lower limit plus 1. So n minus 1 minus I plus 1 plus 1. If we simplify this, we'll be getting n minus 1 minus I. Now we can split this into two parts. Sum of n minus 1 minus sum of I. And this n minus 1 is a constant. Its value is not going to be changed for various values of I. So we can take n minus 1 outside. So we'll be getting sum of 1. Lower limit is 0, upper limit is n minus 2. And here for this part, sum of I, we can apply the formula. N minus 1 into n minus 2 divided by 2. This is what is the formula. N into n plus 1 divided by 2. That formula we are applying here. Now, if we simplify, we'll be getting n into n minus 1 divided by 2. And for very large values of n, your n by 2 is negligible than n square by 2. So it is approximately equal to 1 by 2 n square. And its corresponding asymptotic value is theta of n square. So this is what is the worst case efficiency of element uniqueness problem. The third example is product of two matrices. Here, it is also a non-recursive algorithm. In this algorithm, we are using three for loops. Inside this innermost third for loop, we are applying the we are having this computation. Cfi comma j is equal to Cfi comma j plus Afi comma k into B of k comma j. This is what is the operation we are doing inside the innermost for loop. And now, the size of the input. The input size, we can use the number of elements present in the array as the input size, or otherwise we can use the order of the matrix as the input size. Then after deciding on the parameter indicating the input size, we have to decide, we have to select the basic operation. Now, as we have seen already, the operation which is available inside the innermost for loop is going to be the most time consuming operation, and that is going to be the basic operation. Now, if you see the innermost for loop, the operations available inside the innermost for loop, three operations are available. One is assignment operation, another one is addition operation, and the next one is multiplication. If you compare all the three operations, multiplication is the costlier operation. So this is what is going to be the basic operation. Now we are going to set up a we are going to check whether this algorithm requires all the three cases of analysis, or a single analysis is enough. Here, for this particular algorithm, a single analysis is enough because the number of execution of basic operation depends only on the input size. It does not depend on the additional property of the input at all. So we need not do all the three cases of analysis. The single analysis is enough. Now the next step is set up a sum expressing the count of the basic operation, expressing the number of execution of the basic operation. Okay, so we are going to write the summation formula for the count of the basic operation. Since the basic operation multiplication is available inside three nested for loops, we are using three summation operators here. And the lower limit and upper limit represents the initial and final value of the loop control variables. So for the innermost for loop, loop control variable is k, its initial value 0, and the final value is n minus 1. Similarly, for the middle for loop also, the initial value 0 and the final value is n minus 1. And in the outer for loop, I is the loop control variable. Here also, initial value 0 and the final value is n minus 1. For every iteration, the basic operation multiplication is going to be executed exactly once. So we are putting 1 here. Now apply the formula, sum of 1 formula, that is upper limit minus lower limit plus 1. So first of all, we have to compute the innermost summation operation. Then on top of the result of this, the second summation operation can be applied. Then on top of the result of the second operation, the third summation operation can be applied. So if you apply, we'll be getting n cube. N cube is the efficiency of this algorithm. Thank you.